Aloha, and welcome to the heavy metal meditation number 3. Kaimila and I were talking this afternoon about what we should have as a shared intention for this meditation. And the words that came were unity and unconditional love. And that got me to thinking a little bit about the weirdness in COVID world on October 2nd, 2020, and how from all that I can see, it seems like there's a lot of effort going into divisiveness, into keeping people separate and keeping people centered in on themselves and not sharing. And so the concept of unity for this meditation makes a lot of sense, to put that energy out into the world right now. And of course, unconditional love is an awesome way to fuel the feelings of unity in the world between myself and myself and myself and my partner and the people in my home and the world. So we invite you to be here and share that intention, or if you have something more specific that you would care to work on for yourself, that's totally invited as well. We're going to weave a sound journey for a little while this evening, playing some heavy metal and some lighter metal and some crystal bowls and other sounds. And we're so glad you're here to join us. So thank you for your time and your attention and your intention. As always with the meditations, it's important, I believe, for you to know that these instruments are quite powerful and things can come up for you and it's okay. Emotional space, physical space, the gongs, the crystal bowls, the sound that they produce can shake things up for you. And that's part of their job. So it's nothing that's too surprising, especially if you've been through a journey before. So the invitation is to relax into it, let it happen. If you have emotions come up, feel them, don't run away. If you have stuck parts in your body where pain or tension arises during the gong session, talk to it, listen to it, pay attention to what comes up, because chances are good it's for your evolution. And I think that's a key component of these gong adventures. You're invited to find a comfortable seated or laying down position. Hopefully one where you won't be interrupted too much. We do have a few buses scheduled this evening, and perhaps even a moped or two. Just rest assured they're part of the plan. And when you hear them, just let them move on through. Much like meditation and thoughts coming in, and just acknowledge and let it go. It's not a big deal. If you have water next to you, that'd be a good thing. Maybe even drink a little bit before we get started. Things release in your body, the toxins, they love to have a little bit of extra lubrication to move into areas where they can be eliminated. So it's good to drink water before, during, after, maybe not during so much. Hopefully you'll be relaxed and in a space where you won't want to move. Yeah. So I'm going to invite you to get into that position now. And I always like to, before I start this, grow roots. and get really grounded. I find that the energy flows much better if I'm already attuned to the ground and Father Sky, through the energy from Source down into the energy of Mama Gaia. It seems to me that preparing myself in that way allows for a journey that has a little more impact. And it feels really good, and I don't do it enough during the day, so this is my excuse too. So I invite you to take a few deep breaths, just deepen your breathing. I invite you to bring your breath first into your now, your belly, and then as it deepens, as it deepens, to draw your diaphragm down and to allow your lungs to fill completely. And when they become full, I invite you to hold for just a few moments, maybe the count of three or four, whatever's comfortable. And then to just as gently and slowly, but as completely, release and allow all of the air that's in your lungs, in your abdomen, to escape. And then when you're down in that space, also to hold for the count of three or four. And the invitation is to just to get into that rhythm for a few moments, to feel, for me, that connection to the earth and the connection to Father Sky is something that happens with my breath. And I invite you to use it the same way. And for me, I can feel those roots getting deeper and growing bigger, as roots will, constantly shooting off little tendrils. And as our shared consciousness does that same thing, sometimes those roots will interleave in such a way that my energy becomes your energy, all of it wedded with Mama Gaia. The invitation is to just continue and let those roots grow and reach down further and further into Mama. And at a point, maybe now and maybe in the future as we move through this evening, might open up to Source energy from above. I sometimes see it as like the sushumna, the chakra channel, becoming illuminated and flowy both directions as Mama and the Source and Source and Mama interact. We're going to play for an hour or so. And then we're going to leave for a little bit of silence. And when that's done, I will invite you back. Again, very grateful that you've shown up here. And I'd like to briefly invite in the four cardinal directions: west, north, east, and south, and the energies that they bring and the elements that they bring to create this sacred container for us to do this work. I'd like to invite in the energy of Father Sky and Mother Earth below to form a roof and a ground, a container, top and bottom for this. As always, I welcome myself as the Axis Mundi, that point of reference for which the four directions in the above and the below all coalesce into this channel, this being, your being. And I invite in the spirits of the generations, my ancestors, my teachers and their teachers and the lineages of learning and growth. They're always welcome to come join and listen and feel and be a part of this space that we create together. And I invite the spirits of my progeny down seven generations to the great-grandchildren of my grandchildren, always with the fervent prayer that I can do my part in passing a world to them that has fresh air, clean water, food that can be trusted, and a world where love resides in the hearts of all beings. So welcome, generations above and below, and the cardinals and myself and you. Thank you. You have a beautiful spot.
Thank you. Thank you. meditation is to become aware of your breath again. It's not necessary to change it, just be aware of the breath of life entering and exiting your body. Become aware of those roots that you grew into mama. Be aware of where those roots exit your body. And slowly, joyfully, let your awareness encompass your body as you return from this heavy metal meditation. The little voices are cool and stay. He's a delight. I'm honored that he finished the meditation with laughter. I really don't think there's anything sweeter than the laughter of children. Glad you got to share that. You might find that your body needs to move a little bit. And so the invitation is to wiggle your fingers, wiggle your toes, maybe stretch your arms forward, out. Let's get some movement. Become reacquainted with your body from this new space, this post-gone consciousness. I was reminded while somewhere in the midst of this last hour that what unity means for me harkens to that concept of we are all facets of one grand gem. And what happens to me blessings on those people. They have a hard job. Thank you for being of service to your world. So that unity that is that single consciousness that we're all a part of. So the experiences that I have in being shared with someone. The emotions I feel, the way I treat Kaini, is all affecting all of us. Because it's just one big gym. think they left something. They're coming back. I feel very blessed. And a little distracted. I feel very blessed that the spirits of this land allow us to do this work that's perhaps a little outside the realm of what they've seen before. And I feel privileged that I can do that here. I'm guessing the alarm was saying, Wayne, it's time. Thank you so much for joining us. Hope to see you again soon. But I can hear it. Wait, Wayne, shut up. Wayne, shut up. Wayne, shut up. Wayne, shut up. That's what it is. Good night.